Hello.
What advice do you have for not reacting in that split nanosecond that it takes?
When there's something distressing or upsetting. Yeah. Well, as with most, like, whether it's physical or mental, it's looking after your body, looking after your mind, and keeping yourself strong so that you're ready for whatever might happen. A sense of readiness is really important. So, for instance, if you have some unrealistic expectations of a situation or of other people, and then you're frustrated or you're let down by somebody that you trusted, then the impact is very strong. But if you have developed this ability to see things as being not sure, changing, fluid, and that things can change both in the ways that are agreeable and the ways that are disagreeable at any moment, is this sense of readiness for anything that can change according to causes and conditions, then it means that the impact of that kind of change is much less severe. So in our chanting, you know, one of the daily chants is, I am of the nature to age, I have not gone beyond aging. I am of the nature to sicken, I have not gone beyond sickness. I am nature to die, I have not gone beyond dying. Everything that I love and is dear to me will become separated from me. So these things we recall and we investigate and we think about every day, so that when we do become ill, or when we are separated from something that's it, or someone who's important to us, it's just, yeah, well, of course this would happen. We're very familiar with that. It's not a shock in the same way. So this is all in terms of the answer, in terms of how you protect yourself or prepare yourself for that kind of impact. But when you are in that situation where suddenly something comes at you which is very powerful and distressing, then my advice is to bring your mindfulness to your body and to the sensations in your body, from your head down to your toes, and just feeling the impact of what's happening physically, rather than allowing the mind just to follow the usual habitual mental reactions. Now, if you have, when you do that, and you can feel in certain parts of your body this very intense, and maybe in your chest or in your belly, you just feel this, just make friends with that. So, like, it's a loving kindness to the feelings. Allow those feelings to be there. Don't fight against them. And just breathe. Just keep breathing normally and allowing that sensations to be in there. And just allow that just to drain away very naturally. So there's a practice in preparing yourself for these kinds of unpleasant events and encounters, and then the sort of how to deal with it in the moment when you are ambushed or something takes place and you're not ready for it.